Join us for season three as we sail and explore the Salish Sea in Washington and British Columbia.
I just received a call from the government of Canada. They were asking questions about our passage.
And sail south from California to Mexico for the first time.
Welcome to the Pacific Northwest. We're Ingrid and Jim, a couple seeking new adventures aboard our 37-foot sailboat, Indigo.
All right, we're off.
This is the story of how we learn not to plan ahead too much. In sailing, the unexpected can happen at any time, and even the best laid plans inevitably go out the window. Our first passage after departing Seattle is to Lopez Island with a quick overnight in Port Townsend. And that's where our lessons begin, just hours into the first day. Turns out our regular marina stop was full due to the following weekend's wooden boat festival. So instead, we ducked into Boat Haven Marina with a very shallow and narrow entrance channel at low tide to avoid the high winds picking up overnight.
So after a early morning start out of Port Townsend, we made the crossing and it was quite rough, but we're now making our way through Lopez Pass to our destination at Spencer Spit.
Spencer Spit is another anchorage we'd never visited before. We dropped the hook and pumped up the dinghy to go ashore.
Good.
Bag wine.
Which would turn out to be the last time we'd be able to stick to our cruising plan.
People have been visiting the Spit for thousands of years. The area was first used by the Salish Indians as far back as 3,000 years ago as a temporary camp where they gathered, cooked, and preserved food for the coming winter. The Spit was created by eroding sand from the nearby cliffs being carried north or south depending on the season's prevailing winds. Today, it's a state park, wildlife preserve, and popular overnight destination for cruisers.
Do you like the s'mores?
Delicious.
The next day's plan was to sail up to Rosario on Orcas Island, drop the crab trap with a dinghy, then take a taxi to hike at the highest point on the island, Mount Constitution.
Wow, it's picking up.
Yeah, maybe it's going to come in sooner.
Stronger.
Yeah.
We're gonna have the wind blowing us off the dock here, so that means we gotta get tied up so that we don't fall off.
Closer. Stop.
Very good.
But that plan, too, was not meant to be. With up to 20 knots of wind just outside the marina, we'd have to find a safer place to drop the trap.
See what happens when we come back in about 4 hours.
Yeah.
And it turns out we also couldn't get a ride to the top of the mountain as planned. So we waited at Rosario.
Okay, yeah, there we go.
Oh, he's a keeper.
One.
Due to the high winds, we decided to stay an extra day at Rosario rather than head up to Susha Island in the original plan. It just so happens there was one available rental car in the parking lot next to the marina. So the next day, we set out to drive ourselves up Mount Constitution after all.
At 2,407 feet, this is the highest point of the San Juans. An island group in the Salish Sea between mainland US and Canada's Vancouver Island.
All right, let's go in the tower.
Our plan is to explore many of the islands on both sides of the border as we head north.
The San Juan Islands from here. You can see all the way to Friday Harbor, you can see to Bellingham, you can see Vancouver Island, Victoria. Well worth the trek to get up.
Can you see Russia?
Right, you can even see Russia from here.
Yes, dinner in the restaurant tonight.
It's his lucky day. He gets to go back.
There he goes. This morning, there's a new development. Smoke on the water. Changing winds mean smoke from a fire in Western Washington will be heading our way for the next couple of days.
Now we're heading out to Westcott Bay on San Juan Island, and it's a beautiful day. It's very warm. It's supposed to be in the high 70s today. I'm gonna meet some friends. We're gonna go to the Westcott Bay Shellfish Company for lunch, and then spend some time with our friends there on San Juan Island.
Chardonnay's pretty good.
We'll take those over there.
Now.
This is the sampler.
This is sampler. Perfect. So the super green ones are the lemon, herb, and garlic, and then the yellow is lime, cilantro, sriracha, and the red is chipotle bourbon.
Red's good, wine's good, nice
wine's
friends,
good.
Beautiful scenery. Perfect.
And as we got skunked on our crabbing at Orcas Island, it's time to try it again.
There it is.
With a little advice from friends who live here on San Juan Island.
We just need to come back out here in a couple hours.
So crabs can actually get in, but also get back out.
Oh yeah.
So if you leave it in too long, you won't have any crabs left in there. Oh, we got some crabs in this one. Maybe some keepers here.
So, the only we got to check on the 7.5.
Oh man, okay, that's way more than a pound.
This one you can tell, he hasn't been in here very long. And if you feel right underneath there, he's soft.
Okay.
So he's not gonna have any meat in him. He may be big enough.
Oh, so soft means that
they just molted.
Okay.
They haven't gotten hard yet. So you can take him, but you're not gonna get any meat.
Okay, so
the reprieve from the governor. Use the corner of the wood. And so you're cracking that sternum right there. And you rip this off. And I always just.
And then you can just pull it apart.
Right.
And get rid of the lungs.
Here's the other part.
So even when things don't go to plan, and they often don't, we're learning to go with the flow. Sometimes the serendipity of unplanned moments are what makes sailing, cruising, and life so fun. And due to the good times with friends and maybe a lesson learned or two, we decided to toss the next day's plan out the window and instead stay an extra day in Westcott Bay.